Hey, what is up everybody? My name's Starlord. I hope that you're having a fantastic day, and today's video we're actually going to be looking at 5 character skins that have been made by the community, fan-made ones, that are insane, that should be added to Fortnite Battle Royale. I honestly think that 2 of these skins are possibly going to be added very, very soon in the future. They just look insane. They're so insane that they deserve a spot in the game. Also, before we actually get into the video, guys, please remember to comment down below which of the ones is your favorite and you think that they should be added to the game. And also, subscribe to the channel for more Fortnite games, glitches, guides, all that kind of stuff. I'm actually doing a V-Bucks giveaway sometime in the next couple of days, so if you definitely do not want to miss out on that, please subscribe and turn on notifications so that when I actually do the update video, you guys can actually see it and then hopefully participate and win yourself some very cool, awesome, free V-Bucks. But anyway, let's get straight into actually talking about these awesome character skins. I'm actually going to give a little bit of a background behind some of them too, and just kind of talk about the actual creators themselves. Starting off with number 1, we have this dude on screen right here. I don't necessarily know what to call him. I guess he's just called the Graffiti Man. And as you can see, this is created by Xbox One Blows. Very awesome name, but no, it doesn't blow. It's a pretty cool console. And as you can see, when you actually go around the map in Fortnite, you can actually see on some containers there is some spray painted face on them, and it's like a dude with eyes and like yellow hair and everything. I believe it is a reference to something, but I just don't know what. I cannot remember for the life of me. But the creator, who is Xbox One Blows, actually created this awesome little mock-up of a graffiti style dude with some back bling and his own pickaxe. Of course, the pickaxe being a stop sign with a smiley face drawn onto it, and the back bling looks pretty cool in my opinion. It's got a crossbar because obviously the dude who graffitis like breaks into places so that he can spray them, and he also has his skateboard because, you know, why not just kind of, yeah, throw that in. Also, the actual dude himself has little spray paint cans on the side of his ear pants. He's got some paint marks and everything. He's probably got the craziest looking face I've ever seen in my life on this game. It looks insane. But to me personally, this looks like something that should be in Fortnite Battle Royale. I mean, it is plausible. And, you know, obviously, the thing that he's created, the thing he has mocked up here, is already basically in the game. So why not honor that graffiti man by actually throwing in a cool little character skin? You know what I mean? It would be pretty fun. I think a load of people would buy this personally. Like, I genuinely feel like people would love to run around as this bearded, yellow-haired dude. Personally, for me, I know for a fact I would buy it, just because his, like, whole style itself, it looks very street, and I like that. And also, that stop sign is probably one of the better-looking pickaxes that I've seen created by any sort of fan or community people. So, yeah. Credit to Xbox One Blows. Dude, that is absolutely phenomenal. We're actually going to move on to a series of sets, I guess that you can call them, skin sets, by a dude named Yellow Logic. This dude is very popular on Reddit, and he posts his creations quite a lot. I think he does like one every like week now or something, but I'm always constantly looking out for this dude's creations because they look absolutely insane. And judging by the one right now on screen, you guys can see, this one is called the Cyber Ninja. He's actually done the character itself with the blue glowing eyes. All of the body is like kind of cybernetic and everything. And then also, you've got yourself the actual pickaxe, but it kind of looks more like a laser sword. But of course, he's put the little edge on it to kind of make it look a little bit more like a pickaxe. Personally, for me, it looks like one of the more out-of-the-world kind of designs. Personally, it looks like something that would be in, like, a Crytek game, you know what I mean? Like, I didn't even know, like, Crysis or something? I don't know. But still, that's no question here. It looks amazing. Look at that stuff. I mean, the detail that he's went into here, and all of the shading, the shadowing, and the lighting and everything looks insane. And the character pose in general looks brilliant. I love it. Personally, for me, I love it. I think it should be in the game. I don't know if it's being picked up as well it should have. Like, I know for a fact that the Graffiti Man got saw by a lot of Epic employees, and a load of people from Epic actually commented on it, and that is why I honestly think that is going to be added to the game at one point. Personally, the Cyber Ninja looks very alike to the new one that's coming out soon, the one that you pay, like, $4.99 for, and you get like V-Bucks free with him and everything. I think it's like the Elite Soldier or something. It looks very familiar, so I cannot see this actually being added to the game, but I would love if this dude's artwork made it into the game. Like, if he creates more things, I will actually make videos and keep you guys updated. Moving on to his next creation, which is definitely my favorite, is the Renegade character. And as you can see, this is a mix and match of kind of a couple of things here. So first off, as you can probably see, the beard, the dude with the blonde hair, is meant to be mimicking Captain America. And it's also got the star on the side. And on the left hand side, it's kind of weird because it's like Bucky has been merged with Captain America, because on his left hand side, his arm is actually metal like the Winter Soldier, which it looks pretty awesome in my opinion. I think just this whole character itself looks great, and the beard on that one dude, like, I genuinely don't like the way that guy looks in game. If he had a beard, he would look so much better in my opinion. And also, as you guys can see, he does have his own little pickaxe, which is Thor's Mjolnir, I guess. Is that how you pronounce it? Mjolnir? I think it is. I've got one downstairs. I've actually got like a replica of one downstairs. And yeah, it's actually like Thor's hammer, and he's named it Thunder's Mind, which I really like. It's brilliant. I think this is absolutely brilliant. Now, personally, I do think that the hammer, if anything, the hammer should definitely make it into Fortnite Battle Royale. I would love to pay for that because I love the Avengers. I love anything Marvel, and mythology is just great. I love that hammer and I think it's really good, especially if you are hitting things, little like sparks of electricity would like kind of come off it and everything. I think that would be absolutely brilliant. I love that character skin. Once again, that was by Yellow Logic, and the next one actually I'm gonna show you guys is again by Yellow Logic, but except this time it's more of a street looking one. He calls it Street Ops, which I really like, and it's got this dude. He's got the I think this is what the one of the raptors look like without all of the things on, I think. I'm not too sure, but this is actually an existing character in the game, I believe. And yeah, he's got his kind of like gas mask on, where, you know, he's being graffitiing or whatever. I don't really know. I would have thought that this dude does graffiti, because on his back bling, you can actually see like the gas canister or something like that. He's also got some shotgun shells, and subtly, a little Unreal Tournament logo, or Unreal Engine like logo on the back. And on the actual like pants himself. I really like this, and I feel like a lot of people will really like this too, because obviously, you know, it's very street. People want casual clothes in too. I mean, if you guys put in a character with like a penguin suit and a top hat on, I would most likely buy it, because I don't know, it's funny little things like that that I like. I just love the costumes that people wear, and to bring it back down to earth and kind of keep it like a normal looking style, I think this is brilliant. And you know, of course, the color scheme's great, the logos, the actual bulletproof vest on the front of him and everything looks brilliant. I cannot see why Epic would not make a variant of this skin based on Yellow Logic's actual design. Brilliant work. It looks absolutely amazing to me personally. Like I said, guys, don't forget to leave a comment down below what your favorite is. And now I'm actually going to reveal the very last of the actual skins. I did a video on this a couple of days ago, and it got a lot of views. You know, a lot of people were actually very surprised about it, but as you can see on screen right now, it is a custom-made Dakota's skin by Dakota's wife herself. Personally, oh, it looks so great. I mean, the artwork on this is absolutely amazing. I'm loving like the pants or the leggings or whatever they are. You know, they've got that wolf fur on. You've also got those knee pads with like kind of little paw prints on. The orange or goldy looking thing that's like painted on her arm. And then it also matches her boots and her knee pads. It looks insane. And of course, on top, it's got Dakota's logo itself. Like, you know, the little like wolf kind of logo. That is the headpiece for the actual character itself. And yeah, this character, the female variant of what is on screen right now, like, I love that character. She is my favorite character in the game itself. This one has probably caught a lot of people's attention more than the others, and I know for a fact a lot of Epic employees have been talking about this a little bit on their social medias. I personally think that this will get added into the game, and I actually said this in my other video, but for like content creators to keep on making videos, basically like Epic love content creators keeping their game alive. And you know, when Ninja was actually talking about the plunger with the ninja kind of sword through it, I believe somebody told me that the next day they actually released it. They threw it out the next day. And not only that, you know, you've got CDN the third, his little logo was put into the game too. So it is not completely out of order to suggest that Dakota's wife's skin that she made, especially for Dakota's, should be added to the game. Personally for me, I am very torn between Dakota's and the Graffiti Man. I really want these two skins in the game. But unfortunately, you know, maybe they might not make it in, maybe they will. Only time will tell, guys, you know what I mean? But anyway, I'm gonna actually keep an eye out on a lot of community designs, like such as characters, weapons, pickaxes, and I'm actually gonna do a couple of videos like this every now and then when I get enough of them to make a video about them. So, you know, if that's something that you think you'd like, please remember to leave a like on the video, subscribe to the channel, and turn on notifications for more videos just like this. Again, I did say that I've got a V-Bucks giveaway coming in, out in a few days, and also we've got some Fortnite mobile exclusive gameplay that's gonna be coming out on the channel in a few days. So make sure you do not miss out on that. But anyway, guys, thank you very much for watching today's video. Have an awesome day. Enjoy the game. And until next time, I've been Starlord. See ya.